As post-surgical experts in our area, we treat a lot of patients post-operatively after they've had a total knee replacement. And one of the most common complaints, of course, is throbbing, aching, soreness throughout the knee. And so one of the things that we found helps to mitigate some of those symptoms, and especially if you want to use it during your home exercise program, is a simple TENS unit. But a TENS unit is a great option to mitigate pain, reduce the intensity of the pain while you're working on your range of motion. So let's take a look at how we set up a TENS unit after a knee replacement. I'm gonna do the best I can to expose my knee because I wasn't planning on doing this video today. But a standard TENS unit, I've got some other videos showing you how to unpack the TENS unit and set up a brand new TENS unit. This TENS unit's already set up for use, so I'm just gonna get it out. Typically, I advise my clients not to pull the connectors apart every time you use the TENS unit because they just loosen up and they don't work as well. So what we're gonna do, let's pretend for a moment that I am the patient and I've had a right knee, total knee replacement. Now, the big disclaimer with TENS units is if you have a pacemaker or any other kind of cardiac condition, 100% you have to consult your cardiologist and your surgeon before using a TENS unit. You should always ask your doctor anyway, but I'm gonna show you where to place the pads. So assuming the incision is down the middle, assuming the knee dressing is out of the way, the bandages, the most typical way to apply your pads. So if you're looking at this TENS unit, I'm gonna use one wire on one side. I remove the electrode. I put one electrode kind of low on the side of my calf muscle, not up here at this bony part of your knee, but a little bit lower, more on the meaty part of the calf. On the same wire, I'm gonna apply the other electrode above the knee, again, kind of on the meaty part of the joint. And then I'm just gonna repeat the process on the other side. I'm gonna put one electrode a couple inches below the knee, one electrode a couple inches above the knee. You're gonna sit in a comfortable chair or a recliner. If you're working on range of motion, certainly if I'm laying down or sitting up and I'm doing heel slides, which you've been taught already, I'm sure, or anything, even if I'm just kind of working on passive extension, I've got my heel prop, there's nothing touching the back of the knee and I'm working on getting it straight. The way this is gonna work, you're going to open up your TENS unit. You're going to turn the knob so that it clicks on. I want you to hear it. And then I turn the other one on. I can see a little, the lights shining, so that means that there's electricity. And then one at a time, I slowly start to turn up the intensity. Now for me, once I hit about number two and a half, I can feel just a little bit of buzzing on the outside of my leg. So this is the lead that I turned on. I feel it much stronger up here than I do down here, but that doesn't mean that I'm not getting the same electrical signal. It's just a little more sensitive up here. You want to turn the intensity up to a point where it's strong but comfortable. There is no need for the muscle to twitch or pulse. If your muscle starts to jump, just turn the intensity back down a little bit. I'm looking for a strong but comfortable level of intensity. And then I'm gonna turn the other side up. I'm gonna let it get close to a similar feeling. And then I'm gonna set the unit down and now I can start to work on my range of motion. So let's pretend for a minute I'm on a bed. Maybe I have a strap around my knee. The point of this video isn't really to teach you how to mobilize your knee. It's to show you how to use a TENS unit. But the idea is that as I'm pulling back, where normally I would be feeling pain and I would want to stop, now I feel the electrical impulse, which is helping to kind of distract my nervous system from the pain. One of my favorite ways to work on bending the knee is literally to just lace my fingers over the lower part of my leg. I pull it in, I put my foot flat on the table and I relax. We wanna get to the point where you feel discomfort but not pain. And then from here, I keep my heel kind of dug into the whatever I'm sitting on and I pump my ankle. And if you can see, what happens is as I lift my toe, my knee is forced into this bent position. I might do 10 or 15 of them. You're gonna feel some fatigue on the front of the outer leg. Then I can bring it in a little bit closer. I can do another round of 10 to 15. But every time I do that, I'm mobilizing the knee back. Another application of the TENS unit, I'm gonna turn these guys off. So right now I've got the leads running in parallel. One on this side, one on this side. But what I could do, and I'm gonna show you two ways to do this, is I can unplug the two top leads and I can switch the cables over. And so now without taking the adhesive pads off, I've got these two connected and I've got these two connected. And then again, I turn it on to a comfortable intensity. I feel that buzzy, tingly sensation, but I don't feel any jumping or pulsing. If you want to use a gel ice pack along with the TENS, that's totally acceptable. I've got patients who also use a little bit of a compression wrap. That's also acceptable. But it's just one of those things that I don't really hear a lot of people discussing. I don't see a lot of physicians recommending, and usually because it's just so expensive. A TENS unit like this conventionally could go for $300. But we've worked out a deal with a local supplier. We see so many patients after knee replacements and rotator cuff repairs that, you know, this is something that you can use at home. Again, this would be the setup that I recommend. You have to ask your physician if a TENS unit is safe for you, because it may cause complications if you have a pacemaker or other cardiac concerns. But otherwise, this might be the little secret you're looking for to help you reduce the pain without more medication and get you back to the function that you deserve. So if you have any questions, post them in the comments below. I'm gonna share this video right after I finish editing it. And I look forward to talking to you guys again soon. Thanks for watching.